something. We try to find it in drugs and in sex, and we get all mixed up and we get all fouled up, and before we know it, we're destroyed.
Any girl who isn't me today. I am pretty. I'm a woman. I'm a man. Whatever I want to be. I don't care what they say. I am worth something. I'm worth nothing. I am contestant number 4, Nikki Danielle.
Determined not transgender, because gender doesn't exist in my book. I'm not transsexual because I love the body I have. My state of being is just unique.
I grew up assigned man. There was no way to be a pretty woman when I was growing up in the 50s. And the first time I learned about girls and boys was in nursery school when I was about 4 and a half. And they told us to line up, girls here, boys there. I loved it when the boys were.
I was just having having fun, but at the same time, I was in tux. So I'm like dancing with him, but I'm kind of like this, because I didn't want to like grind up on him. But then I was like, hey, so I'm trans. And his eyes like opened up wide, like pulled up his fist and was like, you're trans? What the fuck? Are you fucking kidding me? We're still not part of like the traditional narrative of what like is. You would never expect to bring a trans person to your household to introduce them to your parents. And I think that's part of like the violence, really. Like, we need to just be seen as people.
Loving people who are trans doesn't have a good word yet. You're attracted to someone of the same gender, you're attracted to someone of another gender, you're attracted to either gender. Nowhere in there does it allow for being attracted to someone who's transgender, non-binary, gender queer, mix of the two.
For me, a pronoun is a sound. What I'm listening to in that sound is, I'm listening for respect, and I'm listening for intent. So, like, if you want to address me, and you're doing it respectfully, and you call me, like, him, or they, you can call me it, I don't care. As long as what you're trying to say is something that is respectful.
I'm, like, seeing this girl right now, and she's another trans girl, and, like, it's like a dream. And I feel really beautiful when she tells me, you know, I'm literally naked in bed, and someone's telling me that I look good, while there's like so many systems and people in the world that judge me for having that very body.
In my first book, I said we need to do away with gender, and I'm clarifying it now. We need to do away with enforcing gender. Someone wants to be a man, okay, you're a man. Great, be a woman. Enjoy the hell out of it. Someone wants to be neither, have a ball.
Yeah. My name is Rita.
My name is Kate Wernstein.
My name is Maria.
What's that? Yeah, the myth about gender that I'd like to dispel is that it's real.